said, whether you say you can or you can't, you are correct. Your thoughts and your words create your reality. So when you hear yourself thinking, I am not good enough, know that you have a choice. You will either show the world that you are indeed not good enough, or you will show that you have the willingness to learn whatever skill is necessary to become better. What if being good enough was a result of your inner confidence? Artists talk about flow. When they are in the flow, they create the best pieces. They are not worried about doing their best job. They simply relax, let go of any restriction, and push themselves beyond the limits of their minds. You see, your mind is the tricky thing. It has one job: to protect you from danger. If that means creating thoughts of fear, it will do exactly that. Your mind is not interested in exploring possibilities or even playing. So to get in the flow, to create beyond your fears, you have to shut your mind. Here is one way of doing that. Get in your body. Put all of your focus into it. How is it feeling? And more importantly, what is it saying to you? Yes, your body has so many messages, but because it does not think, you often don't listen. The body sends you messages via images and sensations. It is instant and profound. The messages don't always fit in with appropriate situations, but that does not make the message less valid, just out of order. Don't judge the messages from your body. Take them in, look at them, observe them. If you feel like doing something because of the messages, do it. Stay present. Regardless of the circumstances, connect your dreams and desires with the present moment. Your body is a wonderful tool for that. Listen to your heartbeat. Just like the first time someone noticed you existed, it signifies life. Life is what you came here for. You did not come here for the money, the fame, or the recognition. You came here because you wanted to live and to love. So do that. Stop focusing on whether you will be successful or not, and instead focus on your heart. Is your heart happy? Is your heart beating strong and trying to stay calm? Is your heart wanting to hold someone or send a love note? Listen to your heart. It is the center of your life. If you can't hear it, it's because you're being too loud. Your mind is still louder than your heart. You have spent years and even decades listening to your mind. It will do everything it can to be loud. Don't try to be louder than your mind. Your heart does not know how to scream. Instead, acknowledge the mind. Does your mind want you to have a plan B? Make one. Does it want you to be scared, to worry, to listen to more conservative ideas? Write them down. Once they are on paper, it will be easier to see that they don't come from your heart. You don't need to just express your heart. You can let your mind express itself too. After all, it's a part of you. And when you do, the mind turns down the volume and you can finally hear your heart. Check in with your body again. The mind will often make your body feel tense, even contracted. Your heart will give you light sensations like a tingle, a buzz, or a coolness. Don't judge any of it, simply observe it all. The mind likes to judge. The heart just observes. When you choose not to judge, you are listening to your heart. When you make a choice, you acknowledge your freedom. And when you choose to give room to your heart, you come back to the flow of creation. Ideas come in and you will start seeing more clearly the right people and the right circumstances for your life. One of the greatest ways to choose your heart is through your words. Your words give you a proactive role in the world. Speak or write carefully. What you say has power. This is where many recommend being positive. Be positive, yes, but only from a place of truth. If you start from the simple truth that you are alive, that the sky is blue, or that you can freely express yourself, there is something positive about your life. But go further. Be the kind of positive person that is like an unstoppable virus. May your smile contaminate your neighbors. May your sweet words lift up the hearts. And most of all, may your own thoughts create more possibility in your world.